this is the acid-based titration lab, and I'm going to show how this lab would work. I have weighed out 1 gram of potassium hydrogen phosphate, or KHP. If you don't know how to use the weighing machine, please go and watch our video on how to use a weighing machine. Now I'm going to transfer this solid KHP in an Erlenmeyer flask very carefully without wasting any of the solid. Now that the solid is in the flask, I'm going to measure out around 50 ml of distilled water using a graduated cylinder. Now I have 50 ml of distilled water in the graduated cylinder. I'm going to transfer that in the Erlenmeyer flask and make sure that the solid KHP is completely dissolved. It's important to make sure the solid is completely dissolved because that's the source of the acid in this reaction. And keep shaking until the salt is completely dissolved. And because it is a potassium salt, it should not take too long because potassium salts are very soluble. You can see that the KHP has completely dissolved. There is no solid residue left in the bottom of the flask. So the flask is ready for use for the titration experiment. There is one vital thing we still need to do before we can start filling the burette, which is to add the acid-base indicator. I'm going to add just 2 or 3 drops. You don't need to add more than 2 or 3 drops. And this indicator in acid medium is colorless. As you can see, there is no color. The acid-base indicator that is used for this titration is colorless in acid medium. Now, our acid solution is ready for titration. Now, when we walk in the lab, we will get the burette, which is filled with a liquid. It's basically distilled water. You have to make sure you're draining the distilled water out. So you can take a waste beaker and put it under the burette and turn the burette on. I always use my non-dominant hand, which is my left hand, to open the tap and open it completely to drain the water inside the burette completely. Always know when you are coming in, the liquid in your burette is water and you have to drain it out. Now that the burette has emptied, make sure you're closing the tap before you pour in sodium hydroxide. I have sodium hydroxide here. It says sodium hydroxide solution. It's corrosive. Now the first thing that we have to do is we have to place a funnel on the burette, which makes transferring sodium hydroxide in the burette easier. And then just pour a little bit of it. You don't want to fill it up at this stage because you have to rinse the burette with your sodium hydroxide. So now for rinsing, I filled out 1/3 of the burette. Now this clamp that I have the burette attached to, if you push these for the front tabs, it will release the burette, and then I would just roll the burette like this so that the liquid sodium hydroxide completely covers the glass wall of the burette. Now the burette is washed. Pinch on the tab, on the clamp, attach the burette. Once again, open the tap completely. Now your burette is completely ready for being filled with sodium hydroxide. Once again, put the funnel back on, and then start pouring sodium hydroxide solution. This time we will fill it completely, making sure that the tap is closed. And actually, I'm going to fill it a little above the zero mark, and I'll tell you why. So make sure you're taking the funnel out. So now, why did they fill it up more than the zero mark? If you zoom in, you would see there is an air gap or air bubble right here. That means there is liquid here, but there is no liquid there, forming an air bubble. So we have to make sure that that air bubble is released before we start the titration. So the best way to do it is first open the tap gently with your non-dominant hand and tap on the air bubble. You might have to close and open a couple of times. This is tricky, this takes some time. Sometimes you have to refill the burette completely to be able to get rid of the air bubble. But right now I can see, if you zoom in, there is no air bubble left where it was. So we could get rid of the air bubble. But we have also lost considerable amount of sodium hydroxide. So now we will fill it up to the zero mark. Once again, make sure the tap is closed. Otherwise, as you are filling, it will also dispense at the same time. Incidentally, you do not have to always start with exactly the zero mark, as long as you can read the burette and you know your initial reading, you should be fine. For burettes, the zero mark is here on the top and the 50 mark is at the bottom. And now if we zoom in, we will see that our NaOH is above the zero mark. So I have to adjust that level. So for that, I will carefully open the tap until it starts dripping very slowly. And I will stop when I think the meniscus, that means the curve, water makes a curve in the burette, the bottom of the curve touches a graduation. Make sure when you are reading the burette, your eye is straight to the marking, otherwise you would be reading it wrong. If we zoom in at this point, I want you to read the burette because this is our initial reading. This is where our titration is starting. So we have stopped the burette already. So now this burette setup is completely ready for use. We are going to move the beaker away and bring the acid solution, which has indicator. Make sure it has indicator. And now at this point, once again, I'm going to adjust the burette, add the conical. If your burette stand is far behind, you can just pull it forward so that you're close to it. And then once again, I will use my dominant hand, for me that's right hand, to shake the solution, shake the flask gently, and I will use my left hand to control the drop, all right? So it may require some practice, so I'm gonna do that right now. So when you're starting, once again, remember to read your initial reading, which we have done already. Before I start adding sodium hydroxide drop-wise from the burette to the acid and the indicator in the Erlenmeyer flask, I have placed a white piece of paper on the burette stand so that the color change when it happens is more prominent. Now, once again, we are going to use our dominant hand, which is right hand for me, to shake the flask and use my left hand, which is wrapped around the burette like this, and use these three fingers to control the tap. You want to have a good control of how fast the drops are being added. Initially, you can add fast. Right now, as we can see, we are adding sodium hydroxide drop-wise, and we are also shaking the solution constantly. If I don't shake it, what you will see as the drop falls in the solution of the acid, where the drop is falling, it's turning pink. So that's the color of the indicator when there is excess sodium hydroxide in the solution. If I stop shaking, you can see the color. That's called local color. That's not the end point. How do I know that? Because the moment I shook it, the color disappeared. So that's why we are mixing it, so that the reaction is happening throughout. So we keep adding. I like doing my titration at a slow and steady rate of addition. I don't change that. And very important is to not to get frustrated. Now I can see that the color, though I'm shaking it, it's persisting for longer. So that means we are close to the end point. At this point, I will stop and change and make the drop addition slower, because we don't want to add too much. This is where you have to become really careful and try to add one drop at a time. You want the color to change from colorless to faint pink in one drop. So I saw that with one drop, the color of the solution changed from colorless to light pink. So at this point, all the acid in the flask has been neutralized, and there is a slight excess of sodium hydroxide that changed the color, and the equivalence point has reached. So now what we have to do is we have to read the burette. To read the burette, I never squat down. I take the burette out, hold it like this with two fingers, and bring the burette up to my eye level, and then read the burette. This is my final reading. Now that we have read our final burette reading, I have put the burette back on the clamp, and I just wanted to show you how would this color look like if I had added too much sodium hydroxide. So make sure you're reading your burette reading whenever this light pink color appears. So now we are adding another extra drop, just one. And I want you to see how dark this color is. So if your acid solution color looks this dark pink at the end of the titration, you know that it has been over titrated.